Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on using the USB both in the system manager and in the computer. So once we have saved the USB information onto the USB from the system manager, we can now put that same USB into our computer, and it'll give us a screen as we're seeing here with the multi options available to us. So a couple things to review. The ones that have the extension of S55, as you see, there are multiple ones as we go down the screen. Those would all be database saves. So the S55 is an indication that it's been a system manager save. And then on the left-hand side, it has a number letter scheme, which is in hexadecimal format, and it's actually given us the date that we did the save. You can come over to the date modified line or column and you can see those dates, but you won't recognize it if you're over on the actual file name itself. The computer will recognize it. That's where I made reference that the actual file will, or the computer will always be looking for the most current save, so that's what it reloads. So system manager always looks for the most current, and that's what it'll reload. If you didn't want to load the most current save, you would then have to either delete that file or hide it under a folder. The system manager will only recognize things that are in the root directory, which means they're not hidden under other folders. Next down the list, we have the ED3 file here. So I had to, in the system manager, load that ED3 file. It reset the computer. Following, I loaded this device.ls3 file. Once it got loaded, it reset. Both of these were the option to make available to us new generic options, new files for generic control. Both of these would have had to been brought onto this USB via computer, and then we have them available when it gets plugged into the system manager. A couple of saves that we did were these text files right here, which are the refrigeration reports. So if I go and click on that, you're going to see that it comes up in a notepad. So it's a very texty looking screen. Things aren't very well organized, but very easy to take that information and move it into a spreadsheet and lay it out as such so you can see it there. So this is strictly refrigeration related information, such as set points and the values and the type of control that we're doing and what have you. The other report that we're going to pull out is right here where it says report.txt. You will notice that it is still in a notepad, but it has a cleaner look to it. Things are just a little bit better laid out. As we go down through, you can see that we have listed virtually everything that's available or has been programmed into control. Such on this screen we're on, we're talking relays. If I go down a little bit further, we're talking sensors, the addressing, the type, what have you. Then we get into the specific set points that are in that given controller. Continuing on down the list, we'll get to the HVAC, we'll get to the time of day, and even here, we have the audit trail where we can see the date and time when things have been changed. Take for instance here, we're talking a sensor. It's a defrost termination sensor. It was at zero because it was a new database being built and it got changed to address 11.5. So every change that was done in the control was listed here. So virtually anything that we did program-wise in the control can be seen here under this report. The last piece is at the bottom where it says CSI, FAI, and MAI. They were those upgrade files as we went through that process. So we knew that the first one was the boot. And if you recall, we went and loaded in the bootloader. It reset the control for us after the bootloader got loaded. And then we would go and make a selection of these other types of files. They, again, will be files that you will acquire from the Danfoss website, for instance. We can go there and these files are sitting there available for us. We can bring them over, put them on the USB, Once they sit here, when we plug them in to the system manager, they will be available for upgrading the control. We do have history that we need to, if we have in fact saved onto this USB available, and you can see that the two files sitting here have an HST extension to them, so that is the saving of a history file. Again, if we were at the system manager, we save the entire history file, but then once we have it saved, how would we view it? Well, we'll actually be doing that offline, and we'll be doing it using our StoreView desktop. So I have that already opened here. I'll open up the open copy, and I'll go to offline before I would actually go to connect. So go straight to the history screen, and up at the top we have where we can load up the history, and this is where I will go and grab it from my USB, which is on D drive, and here are those two files that I just referenced. And I make a selection of one of the two of them. And now it's saying, well, okay, we pulled back the entire history. What would you want to be viewing? I'm going to go to my sensors here, and I'm going to grab a couple of different sensors. So there's three different ones, and we say okay. And now we have those three sensors at plus the suction pressure. Now, when I did that save, it was on a demoing unit that wasn't live, so I didn't actually have live data, and so we don't have live data on this graph. But as you see right here, I can see both the term sensor and the refrigeration sensor. And up here, I have the suction pressure. So we do have all available to us, and there would be a dynamic data in here where the sensors and the pressures would be changing if we in fact were on a live unit. And that concludes the use of the USB in the computer. For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.